দেখা যাচ্ছে?
হ্যাঁ স্যার দেখা যাচ্ছে।
নাও তাহলে এলএল আর পার্সিং। হ্যাঁ, টুডে উইল ডিসকাস অ্যাবাউট দা এলএল আর পার্সিং টেকনিক। ওকে, নাও এসএলআর আমরা তো পড়েছি, এসএলআর সিএলআর এই দুটো আমরা এমনি পড়েছি, তোমরা মনে কিছু প্রবলেমও দিয়েছিলাম করার জন্য, তো সেগুলো একটু ট্রাই করো। আমি আবার একটা অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট সেট পাঠিয়ে দেবো, দিলে তোমরা প্র্যাকটিস করতে পারবে যে এসএলআর সিএলআর এলএলআর পর্যন্ত কতগুলো পার্সিং টেবিল কী করে বানানো যায়। ঠিক আছে, আজকে আমরা করছি এলএলআর পার্সিং টেবিল। ঠিক আছে, সো দিস ইজ দ্য এলএলআর পার্সিং টেকনিক, দ্য লেটেস্ট অফ এলআর টেকনিক। নাও দ্য এলএলআর পার্সিং মিনস এলএলআর দ্য স্ট্যান্ডস ফর লুক অ্যাহেড এলআর, দ্যাট ইজ লুক অ্যাহেড এলআর মিন্স ইট ইজ এ লেফট টু রাইট স্ক্যানিং এ পার্সিং টেবিল, অ্যান্ড লুক অ্যাহেড মিন্স উইল টেক অন আফটার ওয়ান দ্য ইনপুট সিম্বলস টু পার্স দ্য সেন্টেন্স। নাও এলএলআর পার্সার্স আর অফেন ইউজড ইন প্র্যাকটিস বিকজ এলএলআর পার্সিং টেবিলস আর স্মলার দেন দ্য এলআর ওয়ান পার্সিং টেবিল, and the number of states in SLR and LLR are equal, and LLR parser recognize more grammar than SLR parsers, and YAC creates, YAC is a tools which creates a LLR parser for a given grammar. For a given grammar, YAC, using the YAC, we can create some LLR parser, and a state of LLR parser will be again a set of LR1. So means LLR or LR1 same states. How you can see that? Now how we create the LLR parsing table? At first we create some canonical LR parser, and from the canonical LR parser, when the number of states which four part are same, then we'll just use this state and combine this state, means shrink the number of states, and it become the LLR parser. So this shrink process may introduce a reduce conflict in the resulting LLR parser, but this shrink process does not produce shift reduce conflict. It will only produce the reduce conflict. So how you can see that? Suppose this is one LR item of any core set of the LR1 item of the first component. Say S produces L dot equal to R comma dollar, and R produces L dot comma dollar. So these are the core part, and if this dollar is removed, then this is the LR1 parser. So this is the LR1 parser, and these are the dollar is the look ahead symbol. Without dollar we can get this one. So this is the LR1 parser core part. Now from this core part we'll find that L produces ID dot equal and a new state. One state is I1 equals to ID dot comma, mane L produces ID dot, and again for I2 L produces ID dot comma dollar. So see, this is L produces ID dot, again L produces ID dot. These core part are same, only the equal and dollar are the difference. So now we can combine these two. So new state will be state 1 and 2. So new state will be 1, 2, I of 1, 2, L ID dot comma equal, or L ID dot comma dollar. So these two are combined to a new state. So this is the main part of the LLR parsing technique, and from this LLR parsing technique we can create some LLR parsing table same as the before using the LR1 parsing table. See the example. Consider this one. Here this is the, consider this one. Here these are the grammar. S dash produces dot S, S produces dot CC, S produces dot small c capital C, C produces dot D, and these are the dollar, dollar, C by D, C by D. So these are the look ahead. and this is belonging to the I0 state. Now for the go to S, when you use go to on I0, then this for S means that this dot will be shifted here. So it becomes S dash process S dot dollar. When you apply go to C on I0, so a dot, this dot will come this one. So this is the I2. In this way, small c and d, these are the go to of I0. Then again, this is I1, I2, I3, I4. Now for I1, these are the dot has been put in the end, so nothing to do. But for I2, S produces C dot C. So again, we use the go to on capital C, go to on small c, and go to on D. So this dot has been shifted one more again. So with the C, this one for the, if you use the go to on capital C, then this dot will become to the end. When you use a dot of capital small c, then this become again I6. And this for small d, we get C versus small d. So in this way, we have already learned how to use the item set. So see, this is the from I0 to I9, we get the all the item set for the LR1. Now see the core part here in the I9 and I8. See these two one, I9 and I8, these two item sets, C produces small c capital C dot, and C produces small c capital C dot. Only the difference is dollar and C by D. Now we can combine these two, clear? Because these are the core part of this I0, I8 and I9. You can get the core part are same, only the look at the difference. So we can combine this and give a name I equals to 8, 9, I 8, 9. Because it was 8 and 9. So we combine these two and we put C, D and dollar on the end of this, because CD was for I8 and I9, it was only dollar. So these two has been combined and get the I89. Again, observe that there is a another 3 and 6. See, 3 and 6. In the I3, the core part, this core part are same with this core part. On the I3, see. See the highlighter. See, these are the core part of the, these are the core part of I6, and this is the core part of I3. So these are the same. See, only the difference is dollar and C by D. So we can combine these two. So we can get these two. Okay, before that, see, there is a 4 and 7. Again, this is a 4, I4 and I7. This is also same. So we combine these two and again 3, 6. So here we have observed that there is a 3, 6, 4, 7 and 3, 6, 4, 7 and 3, 6, 4, 7 and 8, 9. So these three we can combine, this one and this one. So we can combine. So what will happen for the LLR parsing table? We can do that, and this way we can do this one. So it was already on the LR1 parsing table. Now we just combine 3, 6, 4, 7 and put into the LLR parsing table. So this table will be created. It is as it is on the LR1, SLR, LR1 parsing table, same, only the 3, 6, 3, 6, 4, 7 and 8, 9 have been combined. So this is the LLR parsing table, and we observe that for the LLR parsing table, one conflict may introduce, that is called the shift reduce conflict. So there are two types of conflict. One is called the reduced risk conflict or the shift reduced conflict. So see the condition. Suppose the production is like this. A produces alpha dot comma A and B produces beta dot comma A gamma or B. Now what we observe that this dot has been reached at the end, so we calculate the follow of this, but not required to calculate the follow. There is A, so A is one of the element which is belonging to the follow of A. And again, it has been observed that the dot is the before the small a. So for small a, we can use some shift. So shift is there and reduce is there. So if we combine these two, then obviously it may occur a shift reduce conflict in the LLR passing table. So this is another example which is called the reduce reduce conflict. Consider A produces alpha dot and B produces beta dot. Then there is A and B at the end, and there is another item I2 where alpha dot and beta dot B and C is there. So C, these are the two commons are here. There B, again B is there. So this B are here belong into the I1 and I2 set. So obviously on the one certain cell where B is there, we have to reduce these two I1 and I2. So it may occur some reduced reduce conflict when you combine these two item sets I1 and I2, because look at the same in the two item I1, there is a B, there is also B. So B be common. So obviously we have to put two reduced in a single cell of the LLR parser. So it may occur reduced reduce conflict. So this is LLR parser. And see the canonical LLR example here. Say S dash equals to this one. Consider this is the grammar. I0 is the dot S, and we already learned how to compute the set of items. Then I0, I1, I2, I3, I4. So in this way, I4, I5, I6, all, but the same core part, I4 and I11, so we combine I4, I11. I5, I12, so we can combine I5, I12. So in this way, by combining, we can get the LLR parsing. So this is the second example. Obviously, you can get the LLR grammar. Now, the grammar, LLR, SLR, CLR, LLR, all the grammars, when you use for the LLR parsing, then if some ambiguities are there in the grammar, then again it is possible to parse by the LLR parsing. So all grammar used in the construction of LLR form must be unambiguous, but some cases the ambiguous grammar also can be processed by the LLR parsing. So yes, we can create some LLR parsing table for ambiguous grammar. So consider this ambiguous gamma. Consider this gamma. E produces E plus E, or E produces E star E, or E produces within bracket the E and ID. Or we can write in this way. E produces E plus T, or T. T produces T star A for A, and T produces E produces bracket ID and ID. So this is the elimination of the unnecessary reduction, because this is left most reduction you can reduce, or we can use some T, F, and other symbols. Now this grammar is basically an ambiguous grammar. So our LLR parser can treat this ambiguous grammar. How? See, this is the I0, this is I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6, again I7, I8, I9. So here we have observed that this plus and star is the two operator here in these item sets. Plus and star, there is a plus and star again. And when we get some LR0 items, then if we set the prioritization of the star and plus operators, that is star is the higher priority than the plus, then obviously we can treat this grammar by the LR parser and can create some LR parsing table. So before that, we have to set some priority, like class and star is there. So suppose you write say 5 class 3 star 7, then what will you do? Now we'll do perform the star operation first, because star is the higher precedence than the class. So ambiguous grammar obviously can be treated by the SLR parser or LL parser when we set the priority of the operator, which have the plus and star, or star and divide, or plus and minus, or star and multiplication or division or addition subtraction. So have to put the priority first, then obviously you can do the perform the ambiguous grammar as a LR parsing items. Now see, for the ambiguous grammar is here, class is the we have to set the rules that when we get the class and class is the right associativity, then when you get the star, then the star is the higher precedence than class. So this type of prioritization is required to handle the ambiguous grammar. So it is possible to handle the ambiguous grammar by the LLR parsers. Again, for right associativity or left associativity, we can set and we can get the, and after that we can get some grammar SLR parsing table of the ambiguous grammar, where some this R1, S5 or R2, this type of reduction has been separated, and no shift reduce or reduce reduce parsing will be taken place. So this can be possible for the ambiguous one. Now, error recovery in the LR parsing technique. So an LR parser will detect an error when it consults the parsing action table and finds an error, because the compiler, the main function of the compiler is to perform the compilation, that means find some errors and now convert the original code to a target code, higher level programming language to a basic level language. So before when try to convert or get some, find some error, then obviously we need to recover the error. So this is the error recovery in the LR. So error are never detected by consulting the GoTo table. And LR parser will announce error as soon as there is no valid continuation for the scan portion of the input. And a canonical LR parser or LR1 parsers will never make even a single reduction before announcing an error. So all the SLR and LLR parser may make several reduction before announcing an error. But all error parsers, LR1, LLR, SLR1, will never shift an erroneous input symbol onto the stack, because when an error will occur, then obviously we have to recover the error. Otherwise, nothing can be done. Now, no code can be generated from the intermediate code generation. So error recovery is essential. So there is one panic mode error recovery in the LR parser. When some error will occur, it scan down the stack until a state S will go to on a particular non-terminals A is found, and then get rid of the everything from the stack before this state S. So discard the zeros or more input symbols until a symbol A is found that can legitimate follow A. So basically, parser stacks the non-terminals when encounter the GoTo of SA and it resumes the normal parsing. So when A encounters some GoTo of SA, then obviously parser stack the non-terminal A. These are the rules. And when some error recovery will be done, then the panic mode recovery is that it's simply the scan down the stack. When it encounters some error, then obviously scan down the stack, and then you it can be removed from the stack and get the then the message will be sent that there are some error in the statement. So this non-terminal A is normally the basic programming block, and be more than one source of A. So a different type of error recovery is there. So there is some technique, and routine is there. Error recovery routine also there. Now parse level error recovery also there in the LR parser. These are the steps. Each empty entry in the action table is marked with a specific error routine. When some error encounter, then obviously we can send this error routine. And an error routine replicates the error that the user most likely will be make in this case. And an error routine inserts the symbols into the stack or the input. It detects the symbols from the stack and the input, or it can do both the insertion and deletion. Because if some missing operands are there, then obviously we encounter some error. So error routine has been encountered. Or unbalanced right parenthesis is there, so obviously you can find, oh, there are some error, number of parentheses are not equal. So that type of first level recovery also done by the LR parser.